can start.
Okay, ma'am. Well, very good evening, everyone. Today we are conducting a webinar on future opportunity. Our dignitaries of this webinar, I would like to welcome our beloved principal, who is actually very supportive and student friends. I would like to welcome him, and I would like to invite or welcome our IQSC coordinator, Dr. Shubha Yum. She is also head of the Department of Botany. She is the one who has taken the initiative for this webinar. Welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you.
I would like to welcome our today's speaker, Dr. Manjula Kayar, who is actually going to enlighten you people regarding the opportunities in life sciences.
Thank you.
With this, I would like to introduce our today's speaker, Dr. Manjula Kayar. Is working as a research coordinator, research guide, and assistant professor in Deva University, Bangalore. Dr. Manjula has graduated in biochemistry, genetics, and cericulture, and master's in applied genetics from Bangalore University. She worked on neurobiology of aging for her doctoral degree in Bangalore University under the guidance of Dr. Asha Devi. She completed her PG diploma in National Law School of Indian University in intellectual property rights. She cracked GATE in the year 2007 and KSET in the year 2013 in life sciences. She secured third rank in MSc from the Bangalore University. She was also actively involved in research in lab gerontology in Bangalore University during the years of 2008 to 2014. She also worked as trainee in NIMHANS neurochemistry department and under the guidance of Dr. Taranath Shetty. She was selected as a scientist B in genetics and insect breeding in Central Silk Board after securing first rank in All India examination for two times in the year 2014 and 2016. And she's been teaching genetics since 2005. She has published several papers in the reputed journals with a high impact factor. She has a textbook chapter in the International Nova Publishers for her credit actually. She has presented more than 150 research papers in national and international conferences. She was a keynote speaker for many national and international conferences. She is the recipient of Eureka Award by Terry DST and Best Teacher Award for the year 2009 by Yoruba University. And for her best performance, she awarded for the years of 2017, 18, and 19 continuously by Yoruba University. And she is the BOE and BOS member of Bangalore University, Mangalore, Dayanand Sagar, Jain, Indian Academy, Christ Universities, and even for the Mount Carmel College. Yeah, with this brief introduction, I would like to welcome our today's speaker, Dr. Manjula Kayar, and I would like to hand over the session to the Manjula ma'am. Ma'am, please.
Thank you, Soumya. Thank you for your wonderful introduction. Soumya, I would like to know, is this session interactive?
Yes, ma'am. Maybe at the last, we'll go for the interaction.
In the end. Okay, yeah. Fine. Because I had few slides wherein I thought students will get some things.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, fine. So, very good evening to all. First of all, I would like to say thanks to Shubha ma'am. She is my teacher and she is the main person behind my success, I can say, because a teacher is the one who will actually identify the talents in the students. And without her support and encouragement, I don't think I would have achieved so much. And I would like to thank Shubha ma'am for that. And and thank you for the opportunity, Shubha ma'am. And I would like to say that the opportunities what is present in life sciences, many of us will be not aware at all. We will not know that where we will end up taking biology, because we will think that biology or any other science, any other program, we think that it is just because it is easy. Maybe we are not that good in maths, or maybe we are not that good in technical aspects. And then when we feel that, yeah, biology is interesting, not only interesting, it is easy. Many students, they take it, but it is not actually true. Biology is not a subject because you have to take it is easy or it is of your interest. There are a lot of career opportunities which students are also not aware. Even when I was a student, I didn't know that what are the opportunities. I didn't even know what are the programs in the BSc, which program I should take, what exactly I should choose if at all I have to become a scientist or I have to become a researcher or I have to become a now I'm working as an associate professor. So now if you see this picture, I am sure all of you will be knowing about her. She is none other than Kiran Majumdar Shah. If you see her qualification, she is bachelor's degree in zoology of Bangalore University, wherein we are all in Bangalore. Most of us are in Bangalore. And she is the alumni of Bangalore University. I'm really proud to say that she is an alumni of Bangalore University. We do see a lot of scientists, young budding scientists in the field of zoology or in the field of biotechnology or botany. Basically, when you see, there are a lot of opportunities. Now, I would like to just, maybe I'll give you just to think, because as Soumya said, maybe you have the question answer session in the end. Here, I would like to say about one person who selected medicine. He went for medicine, but then parents' wish was he had to become a doctor. But he wanted to become something else. He came out of that field. He didn't join for medical. He just switched his field and came to agriculture field. He wanted to become a botanist. Then he finished his undergraduate in one of the reputed college, and he found out many things, that is plant breeding. And he is known as, today, he is known as father of green revolution of India, who is none other than M.S. Swaminathan. So if you see the achievements of these great people in biology, I have just taken two examples. If I have to take many examples, there are many people who are actually, they were not toppers in their academics, but still in the field of biology, they have achieved a lot. Even today, if the COVID-19 is there and the people who are working hard, I can proudly say we are the people who are in life sciences. So if I have to start with a thought that is rightly said by Charles Darwin, and it is written in his book, The Origin of Species. Charles Darwin himself was not a very studious student. He used to miss many classes and he was notorious in his childhood. So if I have to take his quote, it is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to change. So we will have to adopt. Whether any positive change is there, we have to adopt ourselves. If it is negative, we have to just leave it behind and go ahead. So with this, if I have to start, there are a lot of biologists. And if you see this image, it is very blurred. That's how is our vision for the future. When you are in the graduation period or you have completed your PUC or plus two, we don't know what field we have to choose. We don't know where we will end up. And we don't even know what are the opportunities. For any people, it is either after PUC science, you will have to take either engineering or you have to take medicine. Only two options. Is there anything else other than that? Maybe CA or BCom or BSc. But what in BSc? Everyone is fascinated about the word computer science. Yes, there is a good scope for each and every field. But when you take up life sciences also, equally or even I can say you will enjoy doing the life science research or you will enjoy doing any job related to that. So this blur image will become very clear if at all you will have to choose any career in life sciences or any career in your own field. So you will have to think, yes, you will have to think before you choose the field, what subject you are taking. For example, you take the combination, which is maybe you take CBZ. Initially, I didn't know that what is the value of CBZ. After finishing my MSc, when I had to enter for job, then I realized I did a great mistake not choosing CBZ, because CBZ is a program. CBZ is a course which is basics of all the biological programs. If you are a CBZ graduate, you can choose any course for your master's, whether it is chemistry, biochemistry, or biotechnology, molecular biology, or even you can go for life sciences, sericulture. Even I didn't even know that we can even opt for other courses like geography, geology. So like this. So this was the mistake what some people will do. You will have to choose a subject which has basic sciences. Basic sciences are very, very important. So you will have to choose the subject properly, and you should know where you will actually end up. Will you do your BSc and then MSc? Then are you planning to do your PhD? Or if not, then are you going for research, or you are going for teaching? So you will have to decide. And then what is the source? Now you will write some exams. We have to write exams. So after the exams, what kind of exams you have to take? What is the preparation? See, now if you take even any subject and prepare for even 24/7, that is not enough, because maybe there you have not decided what exactly you want to do. Just with 1 or 2 hours of preparation, you can achieve whatever you can achieve, whatever you want to do, with lot of dedication and complete concentration. So you will have to make a right choice, set your goals, develop a plan, and you see what are the obstacles. If you can actually overcome those obstacles or barriers, then you are the winner. The day you decided, yes, this is the field I am going to choose, and these are the obstacles or hurdles on my way, and I have to come out of it. How will you come out of it? That we have to decide. Okay? What is the burden? What is the barrier? Or what is a hurdle? That will be clearly seen to you, if at all we are not lazy. And we have to know what is our strength. We have to know what is our strength. And if at all we have some weaknesses, what are our weaknesses? This is called as SWOT analysis. So we have to do that strength, weakness, and the opportunities. So everything we have to find out. And also see the possibilities. If at all, okay, I am not able to become either, I am not able to crack a particular exam. So what next? It's okay. If you have not, you are not able to crack the exam, maybe I'll take up next thing which is there. So you will have to choose your career very carefully. Either your interest is in education based, or your interest is in talent based. If you're a very talented person, maybe you are excellent in doing research. They say that a very good cook can become a very good scientist. I really believe in that, because the minute you are a very good cook, you know how much quantity of chemicals you need to weigh, how you have to add each and every chemical, or even you know how to plan for a thing. Cooking is not an easy job as we think, right? So maybe your mothers will be cooking, or your parents you will be preparing, or even will think that yes, some things we have to prepare. It's not an easy task. Anyone cannot do a delicious food, right? So same way, you will have to choose a career which is talent based, or it is education based. So what is education based career? Either you take up bachelor's degree or master's degree, and then after that, are you going for PhD? There again, question mark. You need to decide by yourself. Or talent based. You are very good in doing all the experiments, very quick in doing the experiments. Or you are very good in writing articles. Or you are very good in, maybe some people are there who are very good in mugging up the things. So it is just, you will have to decide whether it is education based or talent based. So these are the two. Yes, Soumya.
Yeah, sorry for the interruption. Actually, our beloved principal has just joined the meeting, so I just want to welcome him. Well, our principal, yeah, he's very supportive and student friendly. Well, welcome to you, sir, for this webinar, and this is all your support for to conduct this webinar. Welcome to you, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I go ahead?
Yes, sure, ma'am. Sure.
Thank you, sir. With your permission, I'll continue, sir.
Yeah, yeah, please continue, madam. Please continue.
Thank you so much, sir. So here I was just telling about the career. So career can be education based or talent based. So what are these careers? How a student can choose? So we have to know that are we studying or being life science students, are you going to do your BSc, MSc and then higher studies like PhD or postdoctorate? You will have to decide, okay? Because we will know better than any other person that what are our limitations? Can we go out of Bangalore or out of Karnataka or even if possible out of India? What is my qualification? Okay, and also we will have to see that in case if I choose any kind of career, what are my skills? Now, I'll give you one. I think I will have to give the examples of my own because with experience we learn better. So after MSc, when I went for one pharmaceutical lab for my interview, I didn't know that I have to work. I just went with my friends. So they just asked me one question. Can you just prepare a chemical which is 3 molar solution out of the chemical which is 10 molar solution? So it is very straightforward, simple question. And they just want us to apply our knowledge. We have to know what is our skill. No one will ask whether, okay, you are the topper. No one asked me, you are the topper or do you have your mass cards with you? Or how many marks you have scored, what is your percentage? When we go for interview, they'll just see whether your skills are good. So if your answers are correct, are you honest in your answers? We don't have to boast of, okay, I know everything. I know the genome volume 7 or I know the complete botany textbook or zoology textbook. No one needs that you are mugging up the answer. That will never be useful. Mugging up and then learning, it will never be useful. So we will have to see that whether we can actually learn the things. Even today, I still remember when Shubha ma'am used to take my practicals, ma'am used to say, go get your crotodendron, this plant, mimosa pudica, I want, you just get it. We used to run. It used to be so fun having those practicals and then performing the experiments. Ma'am used to show us like that. So it is like teachers who are responsible. When I was in PUC, I still remember they are the ones who identified my talent. I didn't know because I was always scared because from 10th standard till 10th standard, Kannada medium, government school I studied. So I didn't know that what exactly I should do. I was like, okay, I don't know English. I don't know English, so I can't do anything. I just have to sit in the lab. But I used to do practicals. I used to see people doing that. But thanks to all my teachers who identified English is not the only criteria to come up in life. You have to do. You know the things. You have to. You go ahead. Okay, so that is the spirit what we should have. And encouragement, of course, it will be there from the teachers and also from your parents. So we'll have to utilize that in case that wow factor or whatever is there, what is actually crotal area, what we will see, what is that? It's not that understanding. So your interest you have to find out. Whether you have the interest, you have creativity, that's fine, well and good. Or do you have interest in, okay, going out in the society and then you are doing your any kind of other activities or you want to read the journals or you want to become a scientist? So all this and also value will automatically come when you are good in your own skills. So whether you have chosen your medical or engineering or passion, that is good. Maybe you just have to add this threads which have tied here. Because let them go. Now you are a life science student, life science graduate you are going to become. Just cut these threads of the balloon, let them fly wherever they want. But you need to know what kind of career you have in life sciences. So you can choose the courses based on job based course. 101 schools are there, 101 colleges are there. you want to become a scientist, there are so many labs in India or in Bangalore itself. But only thing is, you need to choose the career very properly, and like you have to think and then choose. Now here, when I say this job-based courses, don't consider that.
The session will be disconnected just now in 2 minutes. I request all to rejoin again. Okay.
Okay.
It will get disconnected in another 2-3 minutes. Sure. You can continue.
So, ma'am.
All the participants, I request to rejoin again, so that we can continue the session. Okay. It will continue. Okay. Ma'am can continue. It in between it may get disconnected. Another 2 minutes will take. Okay.
Okay. Fine, ma'am. So yes. I'll just hold for 2 minutes.
You continue.
And later on, I will be telling what are the opportunities, how you have applied, approached for the jobs, kind of facilities are there in the government sector and private sector. Everything I want to discuss, because the knowledge which we get with others' experience, if you have to gain with your own experience, it will take many years. So this is how you have research-based courses as well as job-based courses. I will not discuss this because any job a person can do. If you want to do a job of principal and if you want to do a job of security, both are jobs. But you cannot consider them both are equal, right? So you have to decide whether you want to be the security or you want to be the principal. So that's how you will have to increase your qualification. Okay. So what is a person who is working as security? Why he is working as security? Both are human beings, right? Because of the qualification. If you would have studied, maybe the circumstances are different. Okay. So, but we have to decide if the laziness or maybe you showed some reluctance because your parents were forcing you to study, that is different parameter. But here, students, since you are in BSc, you will have to decide what kind of opportunities are there and how you will have to choose a field. So you are in BSc. Now, after BSc, what you will take, it will be automatically MSc. In case boys will not discontinue for anything else, any other reason, girls, I hope, I think now the situation is different. No one will get married and go after BSc. When we were in, when I used to study BSc, there was one headache. Like parents used to tell, if you are failing this time or if you don't score good marks or you're not a topper, next will be your marriage. So that I don't think now you people are scared of, right? So BSc and then MSc, there are different subjects in BSc as well as MSc. So in BSc, you have different combinations. Maybe it is biochemistry, chemistry, or botany, zoology, biotechnology, sericulture, genetics. Bioinformatics is introduced recently. That is also one more subject. And then other than that, you have applied concepts, applied aspects like nanotechnology, robotics, or even nowadays, you go to any private universities, or even government universities, they would like to encourage the multidisciplinary studies. So that is a new concept now. So there are a lot of sciences. I suggest you take any at least two subjects as your basic sciences, basic subjects, that to have the hold on the subject. It is like you have taken botany or zoology or chemistry. That is a wonderful, very good subject. Because there, as I said, you can go for any field. You want to become a lecturer or you want to become a school teacher, government opportunities are plenty. So CBZ is the main subject where actually it acts like a foundation. If your foundation is very good, you can go ahead for any other combinations. So this is one. And then you chose a subject which is also applicative. So that depends whether you want to choose the subjects having one or two basic sciences. Then after that, you go for MSc of your own interest. Whether you are interested for MSc life sciences, you will have to check. Most of the MSc programs, MSc life science programs, maybe you have taken biochemistry or microbiology, botany, zoology, some papers will be common. So the papers like biochemistry, or maybe you have statistics, or even you study a little bit of botanical aspects of plant biotechnology or animal biotechnology if you are in biotechnology, or even you study microbiology as a common paper. So all these you will have common papers. So there you can study any kind of MSc, any MSc you can choose for. Ma'am, may I know how many minutes are pending?
You can continue, ma'am. I think this is the first Gmail account, the first Zoom webinar we are organizing. Like from this account, maybe it may not get disconnected. So we'll see. Oh, okay. We were just taking that chance. In case it is disconnected, then students can join. You can continue, ma'am. You can complete. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. Actually, that is actually called as luck. Luck is good today.
Okay. Exactly,
so
ma'am.
Here, exactly, this is the courses or programs. Yes, ma'am. So after MSc or PhD, so now we can see that hierarchy here. So what is the hierarchy? You study wherever you want. Actually speaking, the government colleges, government universities are actually best, because not because I have studied in government colleges and universities, I have seen the best teachers over there. Private colleges, yes, they have, but when the opportunity comes, they keep shifting, right? Good teachers will go to different universities. Here hierarchy is like this. So definitely always the IACs or national institutes, central institutes like NCBS. NCBS is there in Bangalore. JNCASR is there in Bangalore. IAC is there in Bangalore. ATRI, Ashoka Trust for Environmental Research, it is there in Bangalore. And even NDRI is there. Nivedi, CMAP, like that many central institutes are there in Bangalore. So these are the research institutes which are in the higher hierarchy. So next, if you see research council labs, ICMR and CSIR labs, DBT funded labs, ICAR labs like Nivedi, or you see that these labs are also there. So for science graduates, we will have to approach these labs. When we go and approach those labs, definitely they'll not invite you with an invitation, please come to our work. It is we as students, we have to go and we have to tell them, we have to prove them that yes, we are interested in these courses, or we are interested to learn things. Don't expect that, okay, we are going and they have to respect and they have to invite. They will not even bother who you are. So we will have to go with our own interest for our benefit. So you will have to approach these labs. If you are aiming for these labs, then coming down becomes easy. These labs or universities, it's easy to join and easy to even do your any kind of research or any kind of academics. So go higher for opportunities which are higher. Even in terms of educational institutes, you can see private universities, autonomous universities or autonomous colleges, state government universities. You see, like this, the hierarchy matters. It is actually very important from where you are. Because even if students are applying for abroad, they are applying for abroad universities and there will be points for that. Even if you are applying for permanent residence, or maybe you are applying for higher opportunities in Canada or USA or UK, anywhere you go, they will definitely check from which university you are from, whether the university is there in the listed category. Whether it is not there, then you don't get the admission at all, or even scholarships also, it is not that easy to get. So you have to select a traditional university, a government university, to be on the safer side. And then you see the hierarchy. So whatever you have done, BSc or MSc, I'll tell the opportunities, job opportunities separately. For BSc, what is there? And for MSc, what is the job opportunity? And then for PhD, what is the job opportunity? So for BSc life science students, you can actually go to any of the labs if you are willing. So there you can work as a lab assistant or lab technician, or you can even go to different schools to teach your chemistry or biology of lower grades. Then you upgrade your qualification to MSc. MSc is the basic or minimum qualification for any of the entry level government exams. Say for example, you want to become a scientist. The exam which I wrote, Central Silk Board, I actually topped, Soumya was introducing, no? So I topped two times. It was based on my MSc qualification. So MSc is the basic minimum degree what we should have to become a scientist B. So scientist B jobs where we can actually apply. We can apply in central government institutes like Central Silk Board. That is one of the jobs which I applied for. You can apply in NDRI. You can apply in CMAP. You can apply in all the central government labs. And also you can apply in DRDO. So these are the places majorly they call for scientist B post. That is the entry level. So after you become scientist B, with increase in your experience and also your probationary period will get over, and depending on your achievement, you will be promoted to scientist C. It is not A to D, it is opposite. Okay, it is B and then we will go to scientist C and then scientist D, then scientist E and then scientist F. Depending on the organization, they become directors and then they go to higher level officers. So here students, so this is your advantage of doing MSc. Then you are not interested to do or work after MSc. Your interest is to get one more degree, that is PhD. So PhD year, again, you will have to go, I suggest, go with your own fellowship. Till MSc, yes, you are depending on your parents. Now you can actually earn your own fellowship. So how will you actually earn the fellowship? For earning the fellowship, you need to have what kind of institutes you are going to work for PhD. Are you going for non-fellowship or fellowship-based R&D research labs? So R&D is research and development. So even in the government sector, there are labs. Even in the private sector, there are labs. So what kind of jobs you are going? Now you write the exams like CSIR or GATE or ICMR. You can write the exams for either NET or only JRF. Or you can choose for both NET or JRF. So after that, if you qualify those exams, now the fellowship is actually more than what you earn after your MSc. So now the CSIS fellowship is with 10% of HRA. And almost around 55,000 is the fellowship after your MSc. So that is one option. And one more option is you go for industries. Maybe you go for drug companies like Himalaya, where they actually respect the graduates of CBZ because they want a person who actually identify the plants, because it's Himalaya is a company which deals with medicinal plants. So they want people who knows about that, and they want people who actually know how to do clinical trials or how to inject or how to do the toxicology test. Chemistry you will be knowing. So here you will be absorbed easily, like companies like Himalaya or even Cipla. Cipla is actually a pharmaceutical company. There also they actually take absolute pure biology or chemistry persons. They want only these people. Applied sciences, the opportunities are less when it comes to core research. Then even people can go for marketing if at all they are interested. There are people who do BSc, MSc, MBA or BSc, MBA. They want to go for marketing of life science fields. So that also is allowed. Or government sector. Government sector, many of them want to go now. Or some of them they don't want, because government sector, it is not that easy, they feel. Actually, it is not that difficult, because if you have decided, you are determined, you will have to go. Even today, Shiva ma'am says that, why didn't you go? You would have been in a very good position if at all you would have gone for that scientist B. Actually, yes, what ma'am said, no, maybe now, because 2014, I got my first scientist post. maybe I would have been next level. But the things are different, okay? So each one's opportunities and each one's preferences will be different. So here, so I suggest that you go for higher post and join for a good position. So next is academic job, teaching. So teaching is now, see, for me, I had many choices because I was NET qualified. I was GATE qualified with 92% and I was also a SLET option. Either you can eat Bisibelebath, anything. Okay, if you don't like one, you can leave it. But if you have only one option, you have to go for that, right? So like that, you will have to make yourself self-sufficient. So you don't have to depend on anything. You choose whatever you want. You make yourself self-sufficient in the sense, your skills should be improved and also your education. Also your resume should be having a very good weightage. Then next is you have different opportunities here. As I said, life science opportunities. This I would like to take 1 or 2 minutes here to explain how we can interrelate different life science subjects. So we say that no, now artificial intelligence is the era, big data is there, and then we have bioinformatics or even genomics, proteomics. But all of them, it is like what is actually the science, which is actually we can say mother of science. It is life sciences. So we can say that any life science graduate can do any kind of work here. So I was a life science graduate and today I can say that in neurosciences, I have very good publications, or Elsevier or Springer-Link, all my publications are in neuroscience field. And this genomics and proteomics, it is just application of the computer knowledge here. Human Genome Project started in the year 1990, but it gave us a lot of other fields to initiate or you apply your knowledge. So this is how the life science opportunities increases. So, but you will have to equip yourself, as I said. So you go for some certification programs or go for some workshops and apply your knowledge. It's not now today, if you are a wet lab researcher, wet lab is the person who works with in the lab with chemicals and other things. You do experiments in the lab. Dry lab is a person who actually does the experiments using a system. Or maybe you will actually take the data and analyze. So you are a wet lab scientist or dry lab scientist. You can actually have a collaboration. So collaboration is very, very important. So this you will have to decide whether you're going for a private sector or you're going for industries or academics or you're going for a government sector job. So private sectors, as I said, pharmaceutical companies and then even agriculture institutes, lot of agriculture, like for example, Monsanto. Many people who are working in Monsanto, they are earning more than the people who are working in a very good cadre, because they pay like that. Corporate sectors, they pay really well. So if you are money minded, you please go for corporate sectors, because there you are. Even now, they'll also screw you up. No one will give you free salary, right? You will have to work and then you take your salary like that. If you want a life which is peaceful, you want to relax and then go, then you select a field where your skill is there and there is a demand. So that you have to do, student. So whenever you are selecting a field, you will have to see whether you are selecting a field with your interest is skill based or whether it is a field which gives you satisfaction. So biology is based on the research, and also there is understanding or hands-on experience on the practical techniques. So it is very, very important that biology is, or life science is, a very skillful, or even we can say it is talented field. So then you can't ask a person who is sitting in front of computer to just dissect out even the floral morphology, they'll not be knowing. Or even you ask them to just pipette out some chemical properly, accurately, they will not be able to do. So it is not everyone's cup of tea. So each person can choose according to their interest. So in the government sector jobs, maybe you can go for non fellowship research labs or fellowship research lab. There are project based learning, and many internships are paid internships now. Even we send our students for paid internship because they pay them. Students will be earning their own fellowship. They pay, and you can actually work there. You are getting your experience letter, and with that experience you can actually apply, or else you can even get absorbed in the same company. So you go for internships in the companies. There are government programs. I don't know whether you are all aware about the programs like BICEP, or even the programs like the Karnataka government itself. It is giving 10,000 fellowship for a person who is completed MSc to get training in the industry based research. So 6 months you will be working with an academic institute, 6 months you will be having an internship in the industry, so that within 1 year you also get fellowship of about 10,000 per month for 1 year, and you are also getting experience. Maybe you can also, if you are interested, you can go to the industry where you got experience, or you can even go to other industries. So this pay scale differs. When I was a student of PhD, because I had JRF, my fellowship was only 10 to 12,000. But here the fellowship is 55,000 today, same JRF. So that is actually what you can get. So don't see the money, you go along with your interest. So government sector jobs, there are so many jobs. With just with your BSc, you can apply for, if at all you want to go for either second division clerk or first division clerk, that is also there. If you want to go for clerical post, or you want to become little higher positions, you want to apply, you apply for UPSC and KPSC exams. That is also not easy. KPSC and UPSC also, people take the subjects like botany, zoology, chemistry, okay, because they are the subjects which they can score marks also, and also it will be their own interest. So that there also your life science subjects are helping you to crack the exams. And also with your experience, you can get a chance for your PhD. And even now they have lot of programs. I don't know whether still that FTP program is there, ma'am. So here that faculty development program, colleges are sending for PhD. Shubha ma'am, is it there now also? So that is one opportunity where you people can utilize. It is there, ma'am?
Yeah, it is there. Still it is there.
Okay. So that is one good opportunity. Or else, even if you can register in the websites like Biotechnica or Help Biotech, biotechnologist2020.com, or even Employment News, please check there. Every week, Employment News, I think it comes on Wednesday, every week there will be job updates, and there will be desirable qualification and essential qualification. If called essential qualification, you should have desirable, depending on what kind of applicants they have got, depending on that they choose. So professional exams you need to take, as I said, GATE percentage is very important here. More than 90 or 95% then you can go to IITs with fellowship for your PhD, or you get CSIR fellowship, ICMR, ICAR, DBT fellowships also are there. This is the old data. Now it is 50,000 per month along with HRA. Then you have integrated programs in IASC or NCBS. Immediately after your BSc life sciences, I'm talking about this, immediately after your BSc life sciences, ma'am, can you see the screen?
No, screening. I think you have to share it once again.
Now, ma'am?
No. It has not come.
No. It may take some time.
Okay, fine, ma'am.
Yeah, it's coming now. Yeah.
Okay, so So this is where So now you have to decide whether you are going for any integrated programs. Integrated programs are nothing but after BSc, you have integrated MSc. That's also along with your MSc, you will get your PhD degrees. So that will be minimum of 5 years because MSc 2 years and 3 years of PhD they consider. So that is there in institutes like IASc where you have to write the JAM exam. Then you have to go to ATIFR. NCBS. NCBS also has its own, their own exam. NCBS is there in GKVK, near GKVK, Airport Road, New Airport Road. Then JNCR, that is also near Jakur. Then ICER Pune. Actually, ICER is conducting lot of very good programs. ICER programs are being happened even in Bangalore. They collaborate with different colleges. Last year, I happened to go for one workshop in St. Joseph College. ICER Pune is giving very good fellowships for the students. So ICER Pune, or even in Bangalore, there are tied up companies and tied up research institutes. So you can opt for that. AIIMS is one more, and also BARC, that is Baba Atomic Research Center, like that. So we can opt here, and the eligibility is BSc. If you're going for MSc, then it is BSc. If you are going for PhD, then it is MSc. So these are all the programs which are available. Then pursuing your PhD, either there are people who go for PhD immediately after MSc, or you have to take one more option. You do your BSc 3 years program plus 1 year program you will have to have. So 4 years of degree, and you can do 1 year MS in abroad, and then you can continue with your PhD there without any difficulty, because fellowships become easy that way. Or else you write the exam like either TOEFL or GRE, go with fellowship. Abroad, I don't suggest you go without fellowship because it will be really waste of money. You go with fellowship, you will also earn fellowship, you can save and then come back. So that is PhD in abroad. Even post graduation also, that is called as MS degree, you can go for abroad. Now in this pandemic situation, you cannot think about almost for one more year. I think those who are in first year and second year, you can plan next. So and then you have to choose for universities which are in the top global universities. So you need to choose depending on your merit, and you will have to write what do they call as you have to write a proposal why you are going, why exactly you need that education there, what is exactly your aim, everything you have to explain, give the references you have to give, good references. You can't give someone, okay, there is one person in IASC, I don't know him, but I'll leave. No, not like that. You have to give a good reference because they have to tell them that you are a good student. So choose your referees properly. Choose the referees who can give a good feedback about you, because they will ask them to mail the reference letter, or they'll call and ask. So that is very important. So other than this, then you can opt for any other fields. So scientist programs I told, and also PhD.